13.8 billion years ago, the Big Bang occurred. The universe at this time was an ultra-hot soup of matter, radiation, dark matter, and dark energy. But in an instant, it was all expanded at an unbelievable rate into what we now know as the observable universe. But this isn't all there is to the universe. This is just the part that we can see. Which begs the question, how big is the total universe? And how much of it can we actually see? Because light has a finite speed, we can only see the portion of the universe where light has had time to reach us. Observations of the distance of far galaxies puts the current radius of the observable universe at 46 billion light years. Now you're probably thinking, how can 46 billion light years be the radius of the observable universe if the universe is only 13.8 billion years old? Well, this is because of dark energy. Dark energy is thought to be the force that is driving the expansion of the universe. It does this not by pushing away galaxies from each other, but by expanding the very fabric of space in between galaxies. A good analogy for this is a balloon. If you draw two dots on the balloon very close together, and then blow the balloon up, what happens? The dots will move further away from each other, as the fabric of the balloon stretches. It is the same for the universe. As the universe expands, the very fabric of space expands with it. While the balloon is a 2D representation of this process, in reality, dark energy does this three-dimensionally. The light that we are actually seeing is from the past, and the galaxies are further away than they appear. In the time that it has taken for the light to reach us, space has expanded in between. So that is the size of the observable universe, but how do we calculate the overall size of the universe? Well, three things are needed. The first is the current expansion rate of the universe. This can be found by observing distant galaxies to see how quickly they are receding from us. The light will have lost energy as the galaxy moves away from us, causing it to appear redder. By measuring how much energy the light has lost, astronomers can calculate how quickly the galaxy is moving away from us. The most distant galaxies on the very edge of the observable universe will give us the rate of expansion. The second part needed is the average temperature of the universe today. This can be found by looking at the cosmic microwave background, which is the radiation from the Big Bang. Current measurements of the temperature of the universe puts it at 2.725 degrees Kelvin, which means that the background radiation is emitted mostly in the microwave part of the electromagnetic spectrum. The final parameter needed is the composition of the universe. For example, how much matter, radiation, dark matter, and dark energy the universe consists of. If there is more dark energy, then there is more expansion of space, and this would change the overall size of the universe. Currently, to the best of our knowledge, the universe consists of 69% dark energy, 26% dark matter, and 5% normal matter. Now, if we take these figures, we can extrapolate back to the Big Bang and arrive at not just a figure for the age of the universe, but a figure for the size of the universe. Inflation theory also helps to get an idea of the size, but that's something that deserves a video of its own. By putting these values in, we arrive at a minimum of 23 trillion light years in diameter, or 20 million times the volume of the observable universe. The amazing thing about this number is that although the universe is one giant structure, because of the finite speed of light, certain parts of it would never come into contact with each other. There are at least 20 million observable universes, all packed into one giant universe, but they are never able to interact due to the vast distances of space. Each observable universe may as well be its own universe, because even if we left Earth at the speed of light today, we would only reach 3% of our own observable universe, and wouldn't even come close to another. Not only that, the 23 trillion light year diameter is just the minimum. The universe could be immensely bigger than that, or even infinite, you never know. And once again, the universe has made me at least feel very insignificant.